not saved, you should run to get saved when you realize all the benefits and all the things that you could have if you weren't. You know, and that's really what it's about. It's about realizing that God loved me so much. Even before I was his, he loved me. But look at all the great things that he has for me when I accept him, right? So that was what we said. We're God's creation, his child. We are loved by God. John 14. That at first you liked them, all right, but they loved you so much that you, next thing you know, you like you love them too.
Amen.
like they really love you.
Amen.
And it's like you can't help but love them back because the way they love you. And it's so wonderful because God is saying, Jesus said, you love my Father, he loves you, and I love you. Because you accepted me and because you accept this gift.
Thank you, Jesus.
Then you're loved. Always loved. It doesn't mean that you won't make mistakes. You think about it. Your child will make mistakes, but you don't stop loving.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
I made a lot of mistakes. Sometimes the same day I make a mistake, I ask my mother something. But because of that great love, that gift of love she has, she still does for me. It's the same thing with God. The enemy likes to make us think that when we make mistakes, we're no longer loved of God. We're, like, we have negated those things that are true in the Bible. The things that are true in the Bible are true in the Bible.
Amen.
It's not anything that we can do to make them no longer be true. And we can step out of the grace of God. But if you say, Lord, I'm sorry, you come back. You sneak right back and just stand. The prodigal son came right back and killed some animals, ate good, and gave them rain. They had a part. Okay, so we know we're his creation, we're his children, we're loved by God.